we represent Cuba. As you know, Cuba is an island in the Caribbean. It's one of the largest islands in the Caribbean. Some day the church first came to Cuba in 1905. And since then it's grown, despite the 1960s, Cuba being taken over by the communist government. The communist government did everything in its power to discourage Christians. The Christian faith being defended, especially in Sunday offenses. At one time, it was illegal carrying a Bible in public. It's considered carrying propaganda from another source of government, and being thrown in jail just for carrying the Bible. But despite all the harassment from the Cuban government, the church grew. And today, Cuba enjoys five conferences. Has 323 churches, 144 schools, and one theological seminary in Miami. Thank God, whenever you oppose God, you can't win against God. That's the communist government has come down a little bit now with all the laws, and there is a little more freedom now, but there's still opposition.
I just want to give a testimony. I was 11 years old, and this lady, this is a communist in Astro was there, and this lady, her name is America Bello, and she is in her house. She got us all the children around the neighborhood, the little neighborhood, and she gave us school, like a school. And from that, the whole entire family of mine are still the African. So this is 50, 60, 70 years old, and we all still.